Hi everyone, I'm David, and on my 18th birthday, I came out as gay to my parents. I grew up in a strict household. My dad was in the military, and my mom was a school teacher, so they were always trying to discipline me. My dad did most of it. He was always trying to make me become more of a man. I had to wake up early every weekend to mow the lawn and chop firewood. I never felt close to my parents, and always felt like I had to hide who I really was, or else I would disappoint them. And to be honest, my dad was kind of scary. But when I finally mustered the courage to come out, things got even scarier. My parents called the cops on me, and I ended up running away from home. That moment changed my life forever. I was headed off to college that summer, and I knew I just had to get this off my chest. Everyone knew I was gay except my parents, and I figured that if it didn't go well, I was moving away soon anyway. I was so nervous that day. I couldn't eat all day, and finally after dinner, I sat them down on the couch and said, "I need to tell you both something. I've been meaning to get this off my chest for some time now, and since I'm officially an adult headed off to college, I thought I should tell you that I'm gay." I waited for their reaction. They sat there in shock, silent, but my dad's look suddenly turned to anger. He got up and started yelling at me. "There's no way you're gay. Are you doing this for attention? Is this what we get for putting a roof over your head?" He was furious. He kept yelling at me while my mom just sat there and cried. I expected this reaction, so I just stood there. No point in fighting back. But I was not prepared for what my dad did next. He struck me across the face. It stung so much, but not more than the betrayal I felt. I was furious. I started yelling at him until he struck me again. At that point, I had had enough. With all my strength, I pushed him, and he fell backward back into the sofa. He was just as shocked as I was. He calmly told my mom to call the police. My mom was so terrified, she ran to the kitchen and started calling the cops on me. I couldn't believe what was happening. I was so confused. I tried to apologize, but my dad didn't say a word. He just said that the cops were going to come and arrest me if I didn't leave now. I started crying and just ran out of the house. I felt so betrayed. How could my own parents do this to me? I just started running with tears streaming down my face. I felt so many terrible emotions at once. I ran all the way to the city center and sat down on a bench. Even though it was in the middle of the night, the streets were still busy and lit up, and it made me feel some comfort that I wasn't completely alone. I was just trying to catch my breath until a group of guys came up to me. I was nervous. One of the guys said, "That's a nice looking jacket. Mind if I try it on?" I stood up and said, "Look, I've had a really rough night. Can you just leave me alone and pick on someone else?" This got him furious. He shoved me to the ground, and the rest of his friends started beating me up. I thought I was gonna die until suddenly I heard a voice. "Hey, cut that out, jerks!" Someone came running and threw the guys off me with ease. I finally came to my senses and saw a guy, roughly around my age, give me a hand and say, "Are you all right? You don't look so good." I took his hand and dusted myself off. I was sort of taken with him. He had kind of a mysterious look. He was tall, dark, and handsome, and was wearing a leather jacket and ripped jeans. For some reason, I felt embarrassed being around him. He seemed so cool, and he saved me. He introduced himself as Frank and said that if I don't have a place to stay tonight, I can stay with him. I accepted. At this point, I would probably do anything he asked. We got to his place, which was actually the basement of a gay nightclub. Frank told me that the owner of this bar is a really nice guy who takes in kids who have nowhere else to go. Frank ran away from home when he was about 12 years old. His dad was an alcoholic who would often beat him, so he took off and never looked back. Frank now lives at the clubhouse with several other boys. At night, he bartends at the club, and during the day, he pickpockets local tourists, does a few magic tricks, and panhandles for money. I really admired Frank. He didn't care what anyone thought of him, and he did whatever he wanted. I asked him to show me how to earn money too. Over time, he taught me how to rip off tourists, how to play three-card Monty, and together, we were raking in a lot of money from unsuspecting people. We spent a lot of time together, and soon I developed a crush on him. I think he felt the same way too, because he was always looking for an excuse to touch me or look at me. I was having such a great time with Frank that I practically forgot all about that horrible night. This was going to be my life now, screw my parents, and screw college. I could die happy, spending all my days holding hands with Frank. One night, when Frank and I were back at the club bartending, I stared at him while trying to make a cocktail, and we made eye contact. He smiled at me, and my heart jumped. I wish that was the only thing that jumped, but my stupid hands dropped the drink I was holding, and there was glass all over the floor. I was so embarrassed. I started picking up the pieces, but one of the glass shards cut my hand. Frank ran over and grabbed my bleeding hand and rushed me to the bathroom. He left and came back with a first aid kit and patched my finger up. I couldn't even look at him in the eye because I was so mortified. He looked at me and just started laughing. "Next time, let me handle the drinks. I don't want you getting hurt again." Then, I did something unexpected. I was flooded with so much emotion and love that I leaned over and kissed him. He kissed me back, and we went back to the clubhouse and just cuddled together all night. I told Frank that I loved him and that I would do anything for him. He just chuckled and thought that I was just being naive, even though I meant it. I thought nothing could ruin this moment. Suddenly, we heard a loud knocking on the door. It was the cops. They barged in and grabbed Frank. I tried to hold on to Frank, but they kicked me in the ribs and told me to stay down as they arrested him. I was screaming and crying. I begged them to stop hurting him, but they didn't listen. The whole time, Frank was yelling at them and telling me he loved me back and that no matter what the cop said, it wasn't true. I had no idea what was going on, and just like that, Frank was taken from me. I ran upstairs to grab the club owner in his office. "They took Frank! The cops took Frank!" I yelled. The club owner just looked at me and said, "Well, of course they did. I called them. Turns out Frank was stealing money from the cash register every night." I stood there, shocked. There was no way that was true. Frank wasn't like that. That night, I laid in my bed trying to piece together what happened. I loved Frank, but how much did I really know about him? I mean, I know he runs a few scams here and there, but he would never steal from the club owner, right? I mean, that man practically raised Frank. Could there be more to this that they aren't telling me? I didn't know what to do or who to side with. All I knew is that I loved Frank, and I wanted our life together back, and was willing to do whatever it took. Coming out can always be really difficult. Even today, acceptance across different cultures, religions, and groups of people can be hard to find. If you have advice to share with others or your own story, share it with us in the comments below. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more stories like David's.